consciousness is a real problem. Some people say it isn't a problem at all and we shouldn't even talk about it. Others say it's the greatest problem for science. I don't know, but for me, it is the heart of the problem that I'm interested in. Look at it this way. Here I am looking at the world. It feels like this. It feels as though there is a me inside there, inside my head, looking out at a world out there. It feels as though this me has consciousness and has free will, is in control of my arms and legs and the things that I do and lives my life and is in some way a persistent being that goes on through my life. Now, as soon as you start to think about that scientifically, you realize that that has to be wrong. For one thing, if you look inside a brain, let's say you cut the skull and open it up and look inside, what do you see? You see millions of neurons all interconnected in all sorts of complicated ways. You do not see a little homunculus, a little person in there, you know, that's looking out. Dan Dennett explains it even more clearly in his perhaps infamous book, Consciousness Explained. Many people say it should be called Consciousness Explained Away. I disagree with them. I think he did a very good job. One of the things that he explains in there is not only can there be no little person looking in there, but there isn't even a kind of central place. It's all parallel processing. It's all information going through in complicated ways. There isn't a middle into which the impressions come, where consciousness happens and from where the instructions go out. It's all going through in parallel, multiple stories going through. Now, this suggests that the idea of a kind of central executive self is it can't be the kind of thing we think it is. There's a fundamental problem at the heart of how we experience the world, at the heart of consciousness. Now, I said look at it scientifically. Let's look at it another way. Let's look at it from the point of view of our own experience. I'm particularly interested in disciplined experience. I've been meditating for 20 years, and if you sit and look steadfastly into experience, you can do many things. One of the things you can do, when you learn to calm the mind so that it's still, look, who is calming? Who am I? Look for the self. You don't find it. You find the consciousness then changing, becoming quite different. And it can get to the point where there ceases to be self and other. And kind of self sort of falls out and there simply becomes experience. Now, whether this is a true of you, I don't know. But it raises all those questions which have been the heart of the philosophy of mind for centuries. Is there just one kind of stuff or two? Because essentially when my starting point about it feels as though it's me in here having a subjective experience of a real world suggests there's two kinds of thing. You know, there's mind and there's matter, and that doesn't make sense. So really my feeling about consciousness is this: something is wrong with our view of the world, deeply wrong, because whichever way we look at it, it doesn't seem to make sense. Somehow our science is going to have to change dramatically before we can really make sense of consciousness and answer those difficult questions. And I look forward very much to what that's going to be.